The legality of the transfer of 125 million pesos in confidential funds to the office of Vice President Sara Duterte in 2022 being questioned before the Supreme Court. Our very own Adrian Ayalin now joins us with details. Adrian, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, critics of the 125 million peso confidential funds of the office of the Vice President filed a petition for certiorari before the Supreme Court this morning. The group of petitioners led by Attorney Christian Monsod, Attorney Katrina Monsod, Attorney Barry Gutierrez, Attorney R.B. Santiago, and former Department of Finance Undersecretary Shelo Magno said the transfer of funds from the Office of the President to the OVP as confidential funds and expenses was unconstitutional. Respondents to the petition were the OVP, the Office of the Executive Secretary, and the Department of Budget and Management. The petitioners noted that the appropriation done by the DPM was a clear usurpation of the legislative power of Congress to create and fund an item that has not been done by Congress itself. The petitioners noted that the OES claimed that the confidential fund release was authorized to cover funding requirements of the OVP. They also noted that the DBM Secretary Amina Pangandaman had clarified that since the money came from the contingent fund, it was not considered a transfer, but was merely a release. The petitioners, however, said the supposed transfer from contingent fund to confidential funds was not sanctioned by law, as they pertain to two completely different allocations provided for under the General Appropriations Act of 2022, particularly the Good Governance Program and the traveling expenses. In a press conference after the filing, the group said they are focusing on the declaration of unconstitutionality of the supposed transfer of funds and not on possible criminal liabilities of the respondents.
Joining us now, one of the petitioners, Attorney Barry Gutierrez. Attorney Gutierrez, nice to talk to you again. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Carmina, and good afternoon.
Very eventful morning that you had today. Talk us through what exactly this petition means, because there are several components to it. There's the request, there's the transfer or release, there's the use of it, and based on your petition, you're also part of the prayer is also to return the 125 million pesos that was used. Go ahead, Attorney Gutierrez, and talk us through all these various components.
Well, at heart, what we're really asking for is a declaration of unconstitutionality. And that is essentially anchored on the simple fact that the whether you call it a transfer, whether you call it a release or an augmentation, the money went into a supposed confidential fund under the office of the Vice President. And the truth of the matter is, if you look at the General Appropriations Act of 2022, there is no such confidential fund item under the OVP budget. If we'll recall, the 2022 budget for OVP was still applied for and is still anchored on the submissions of the outgoing Vice President, former Vice President Leni Robredo, and she did not ask for confidential funds, neither was she given any confidential funds. So what we're saying here is, under the Constitution, there is no power on the part of any executive agency to create a fund which is not created by law first. So that's really the main point that they're asking the Supreme Court to rule on, and to declare that the 125 million pesos in confidential funds given to the office of the Vice President as per their request in 2022 is unconstitutional and illegal, and that amount should actually be returned to the National Treasury.
Was the request? Are you also questioning the request? Do you find the request, because it all started from there, do you find the request illegal or at the very least laziness?
Yes. To begin with, they made it very clear in the request that what they were asking for was confidential funds. In fact, the nature of the fund was first characterized in that request made by the OVP to the Department of Budget and Management. So any actions taken by DBM subsequently were triggered and anchored on that characterization by the OVP request. So yes, where in effect, the request itself which asked specifically for confidential funds, even if they clearly knew that confidential funds were not included in the 2022 OVP budget. That itself is already improper and, in violation of the Constitution.
Apart from, as you allege, that it's in violation of the Constitution, the underlying issue here as well is the whole process by which they were itemizing or not their budget. Do you think that at the very least there's some sort of laziness there on the part of the Office of the Vice President when it just belatedly thought we need confidential funds and therefore we're going to tap into the contingent fund of the president?
Well, yes, that's really one of the many irregularities that attended this entire process. And the funny thing here is, and we point this out in the petition, they were asking for confidential funds, but the purposes that they actually mentioned for which supposedly these confidential funds would be used had nothing to do with surveillance or security, but were rather intended for augmentations of a good governance fund and for financial assistance. So, these are existing budgetary items. So if all you wanted was, additional funds for these existing programs, then the money should have gone to these programs directly and not to a confidential fund, which under the law has more liberal requirements with respect to reporting. So one of the issues that we also raise in this petition is that this can actually be an indirect effort to evade accountability, to defeat the provisions of the Constitution which insist on transparency with regard to spending of public monies through the simple expedient of putting the money in a confidential fund rather than in a regular item of budget.
Why is it important, Attorney Gutierrez, to question it right here, right now?
Well, this entire thing was actually triggered due to the deliberations in Congress, where it was revealed that there was, in fact, this appropriation of confidential funds in 2022 in clear violation of the General Appropriations Act of 2022 and the Constitution. Now, why is it important? It's important because this is an issue of accountability. This is an issue of proper spending of people's money. All the provisions of the Constitution relating to the General Appropriations Act, the limitation on transfers, they are all intended to ensure that public funds, people's money, taxpayers' money, are spent appropriately, that they are spent in accordance with actual public purposes, and that the public officers responsible for them do not abuse the use of these funds. And using them in such a way that transparency is defeated, using them in such a way that violates these rules, opens the door to a lot of abuse, to corruption, possibly. So we need to insist on a strict application of these constitutional requirements, because at the end of the day, these are the rules that ensure that public monies are spent responsibly, and the people's funds are spent in a manner that actually benefits the public.
Attorney Gutierrez, is it all those things that you mentioned, and not about the Vice President herself?
Well, it's in the petition, the fact that the Vice President is a respondent is incidental to the office that she actually occupies. Because at this stage, it's clear the request was made by her office. The fund was transferred to her office. It was spent by her office. So accountability really lies with that. This is not anything personal. This is very, very clearly anchored on constitutional provisions. And it is clearly anchored on the principle of accountability of agencies that actually have public funds at their disposal. Because if we do not insist on this, then it opens the door, as I said earlier, to possible abuse. And, we want to avoid that at the outset.
As you were pondering on filing this petition, was there any space left for politics, Attorney Gutierrez?
I won't be surprised if in the coming days the spin will be that this is political. But speaking for myself and the other petitioners, our clear intention here is to insist on the constitutional order that we feel has been violated here. That's why we're bringing it to the Supreme Court, and we're throwing this entire issue for the resolution of the Supreme Court, because we think that there are very, very clear constitutional issues here. There are very, very clear legal issues here. And all of them actually relate to the deeper and probably more important issue of public accountability. So that's our intention. Although, you know, as I said, I won't be surprised given the personalities involved that then ultimately some will claim this is politically motivated. But on our part, this is a clear issue of constitutionality and in public accountability.
And if since you mentioned public accountability, why single out, or how different, state to us the difference between the office of the vice president and the use of the confidential funds which were released, transferred to her office, and all the other civilian agencies who have been using confidential funds as well, to the advantage of the Filipino public? That we don't know, but why single out the office of the vice president here?
Well, they were singled out precisely because there is a clear it is clearly documented, and there is a clear record that a transfer was made in 2022, despite the fact that there was an absence of confidential of an item relating to confidential funds in the OVP budget for 2022. So that's really the core factual issue on which we are anchoring the constitutional challenge here. Now, you're right. There were, you know, additional confidential funds issued in 2023, and there were additional funds issued to other agencies. But that's not the issue we decided to focus on. We're focusing on the propriety of Congress actually giving an additional, not Congress, the executive giving an additional fund to an agency where that fund is not provided for under law. That's why our main contention is this involves a usurpation of legislative power. So clearly, that point is anchored on the factual occurrence in 2022, where despite the absence of a constitutional fund, a confidential fund in the law, there was a request made and there was a transfer made. And that money was actually spent as confidential funds. And, you know, if we allow that, if we allow a post-GAA transfer of funds in this way to a confidential fund which is not covered by the same level of accountability as regular appropriations, that's a dangerous precedent. And that, as I said earlier, opens the door to a lot of abuse. Now, whether on the issue of whether confidential funds themselves should be questioned, well, we leave it to subsequent cases to explore that particular question.
Attorney Gutierrez, named in your petition as well are the Office of the Executive Secretary and the Department of Budget and Management. What is their accountability in this whole issue?
Well, they're the ones who released the fund, ultimately. If the request was made by OVP, the approval and release to OVP, or transfer, depending on how you characterize it, was done by DBM and the Office of the President. So, to achieve full relief in this matter, all the agencies that had a hand in what we are claiming is an unconstitutional process should be named as respondents, and they were in this petition.
All right. Now, you know what the confidential funds have been called, Attorney Gutierrez. They've been called the new game in town with this petition. How do you think this is going to impact that game, and will it ultimately lead to that path wherein there's going to be a stop, a halt to the use of confidential funds inappropriately by civilian agencies? Go ahead.
Well, you know, ultimately, our hope is the Supreme Court will, when it rules on this, will issue a clearer clarification on the use, the creation of confidential funds by through executive action. We're not really touching the issue of the propriety or appropriateness of confidential funds themselves, mm-hmm. if they are provided for specifically in the General Appropriations Act, but at least on the specific issue of whether the executive acting on its own can create a confidential fund not provided by law. We hope that the outcome of this case will offer clarity to that, and at least the door to abuse that is opened by allowing that can be closed.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Barry Gutierrez there, one of the petitioners against the Office of the Vice President, DBM, and the Department of Budget and Management have been named in this petition questioning the use, the transfer, the release of confidential funds. By the way, you're also seeking that the $125 million be returned?
Yes. To the National Treasury, yes. Mm.